I wanted to wake up and see like a fucking white banker being pulled over in his Mercedes by black cops and just beaten half to death for no fucking reason. You know? I wanted to see a bunch of Puerto Ricans working. I wanted to go. I'm just kidding. Come on. I wanted to see stuff change, man. I wanted to see a couple of banker white businessmen rich and their wives mowing the lawn, and a couple of Mexicans sitting on a porch saying, "You missed a spot, S.A." You know what I'm saying? Shit like that. It's a historical thing. This is, of course, it's generalizing. It's all generalizing. I know there's exceptions for everything. But in a general sense, there's a lot more white people who have what they call white guilt. You know that concept, white guilt? And then there's a lot of black people who want reparations for slavery. But not all. There's some, actually. Some on each side, right? We got some white kids that walk around like they're from the ghetto. Like they live in the suburbs in a fancy rich house and they're like, "Yo, what's up, motherfucker? Shit is rough in the motherfucking suburbs and shit. I'm tired of being held down and shit." Like, who's holding you down, Bernie Weinstein? Are you being held down by the condo association? Fucking raging against the cul-de-sac? I hate these little bastards. I hate all young kids that act like gang. You know, they wear the do-raps on their heads. Have you seen these assholes? They walk around, their heads are all wrapped up. They're walking down the street, there's like five of them. I said, "Were you guys wounded? What happened to your heads?" So I bumped into one of them. He's like, "Yo, what's up, motherfucker? You bumped into me, son? I'm gonna fuck you up." I said, "That is adorable. Come here and give me a hug." That's just precious. So he said, "Why don't you say, excuse me?" So I carry a gun a lot of times in case somebody hurts my feelings. So I pulled out the gun. I said, "I'm gonna fucking kill you now, you little motherfucker." And his friends are like, "It's all good, dog, it's all good." I said, "It's all good for me and for you two, but it's not really all good for him, is it? There's a fucking gun pointed at his head. I would say it's mostly bad." I said, "I'm gonna shoot you in the fucking head unless you could spell excuse me." He didn't make it. And then we got some black people that want what they call reparations. They want to be repaid for what happened here in their own country. Now, I understand that. I do. I don't want to pay anything because I wasn't there. I wasn't there. But what I want to do is I want to allow any black people that want reparations, it's not going to be all of them. You'll be surprised how few. They come and they get to own a white kid that wants to be black. And I think everybody will be happy on both sides. Okay, I wanted to wake up and see Obama make those kind of fucking changes. I was looking for that. I was looking to see a black woman sitting on a porch, little white kid there chained up to a fucking railing, and say, "Go get me a grape soda, crackle." I actually had a white person write me a letter on that one. But it was upsetting that I said grape soda. That like that's a stereotype. I had to write back, "Dear Dizzy Cunt, you should have got upset that there was a slave involved." Like it was a slavery joke. That was the offensive part of it. And that didn't even get you. At least get offended at the right shit, you know what I'm saying? Black dudes love me, man. Black dudes like me so much, sometimes I feel like a chubby white girl. I really do. I love black people. Is there a lot of black people here tonight? Not really, right? It's hard to do good black jokes if there aren't a lot of... I know there's a few black people, but not enough. You know, if we start doing black jokes, it's like just a Klan meeting with a few black people. Black people inspire so much comedy with me because of their richness of their culture and the way black people are. Black women are the fucking great. Big, fat black women with the big tit, the ones that are always yelling and shit. But they're always happy, like, they're yelling, but they're not angry. They're like, you crazy, motherfucker, you know, shit like that. And you get a black woman will hug you. As I'm telling you, I'll go up to a black woman, and it's like, oh, mama, you know, and they come over. And they'll give you a hug. I had a black woman hug me after a show once. Her tits were out to here. They were like 90 pounds. She pushed my head right into the fucking middle of them like there was treasure in there. And I couldn't breathe. I couldn't see. But I knew everything was going to be all right, baby. I was having sex with this Jamaican woman once and... No, and right in the middle of it, she said, make me remember you. So I punched her in the pussy. That's right, she'll remember that, won't she? She'll be like, one time back in the day, the crazy white boy punched me upon the pussy. This girl I was going out with, man, she drove me nuts. I always picked girls that tortured me psychologically for whatever reasons. You know, shit with my mother when I was like, who knows what it is. And I would never, like, lash out and say mean things. I really wouldn't, even though you probably think I would. I wouldn't. I'm not that type of person. But I got close once to say, calling her, you know, something bad. And we're watching television, and I was steaming mad at her. And she's like, what would our names be, Mike, if we were famous, like Brangelina or Bennifer? I said, Munt. The C word, that's what they call it now, the C word. You know who hates the C word? Cunts. Nobody else. It's unbelievable. I had one come up to me after a show one night. She's like, I hate that word. I said, well, you probably hear it an awful lot, don't you? And then she said, would you call a black person the N word? And I was like, if I had a lot of money on the game, see, it's the white people. My brother laughed his ass off. I know there's some black folks in the back who are probably laughing because they're saying, oh, he's being honest, like he's being real. Now, the funny thing is, the N-word is just called to black people because of their skin color, which I don't do. I don't even use it in my show. Not because I'm afraid of black people. I don't want to hurt their feel. Like older black people or young black kids call each other the N-word. Oh, N-word. When their grandmother fucking hears it, it reminds them of the way they were treated. Then there's nothing really to feel good about. So I don't do it because of that reason only. I'm not afraid of black people. I will fucking kill a black person. I will fucking shoot you, run you over, pee on your dead fucking black body. But I will not call you the N-word because I was raised properly. So the N-word is my only, like, no-no word. I just don't use it. Just, it's not worth it. But young black kids do it, whatever. You know what I mean? Because they're not experiencing what their grandparents and great-grandparents experienced. So it's a whole different thing to them. And that's fine. I got no opinion on that. I'm not black. What the fuck do I know? But I do know that there's a theory behind it that if we call each other the N-word, it'll make it a fun word. And then it will take the power out of it. You steal the word back, essentially. And black people said, look, white motherfuckers aren't going to have this word anymore to hurt me with. So we're going to use it ourselves in a positive way between ourselves, not between other people. Although I've been called the N-word by some of my black friends. I don't even know what the fucking rules are with that. I don't even know if I'm allowed to laugh or agree. Am I like, agree? Am I allowed to go, yeah, that's right, I'm your N-word, son. You know, I don't know how to even deal with it. All I do is just point at him and say, he said it. So I'm just thinking that cunts should do the same thing. Just call each other cunts. Fuck it, have fun with it. Be like, Jennifer, you're my cunt. Do you know Barbara? Barbara's my ace number one cunt. Are you kidding me? Imagine going to the mall and just seeing, hey, my cunt, what's up? Man, cunt, what's up, cunt? And if one of them gets upset, be like, cunt, please. You know what I'm saying? Like, just have fun with it. Where my cunts at? Where my cunts at? Ho! All the hoes in the house say cunt!